Cause life is short and dark is cheap, so fuck what people say. When I was 12, a crazy lady told me lead the way. I shed a tear cause it was real, swore to never stray. Now every second is a classic when nothing lasts. Gotta take a moment and appreciate the fact that this world is turning faster and faster. And when she felt the real, it's hard to tolerate the plastic.
What's up guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Abdul, and in this video we're gonna be talking about how to escape the worthiness trap. Now look man, many people are in this rut man. They're always trying to prove themselves to everybody around them. They're always trying to be accepted by those around them. And here's the truth, that is a battle that you will never win, because there's always somebody who just does not like you, who will not like you, who just thinks you're the awful person, who won't accept you. Look at Jesus man, that person was the GOAT, right? He did all of this good stuff trying to save people, whatever, and guess what? He got crucified. And so here's the truth. With whatever you do, there will always be somebody who hates you. There's always going to be somebody that will not accept you for who you are. And here's the truth. Fuck it, right? It doesn't matter, does it? Because the truth is, in this video, I'm going to be explaining to you exactly how you need to accept yourself. Because that is the essence of why you're seeking everybody else's acceptance and why you don't feel worthy. Because you don't accept yourself. Escaping the worthiness trap is threefold, all right? Number one, you have made an agreement, whether to yourself or, you know, based on what other people have said. An agreement is something that you agree to, right? It is a mutual understanding that, yes, this is who I am. For example, with my life, when I was in elementary school, man, a lot of kids would tell me, yo, Abdul, you're annoying, right? That is what somebody told me. And you know what I did? I agreed to it. I said, yep, I agree with you. You're right. I am annoying. And what this did is later in my life, it was harder to express myself. And I never understood why this was, right? Now that I'm a YouTuber and I'm making YouTube videos, I need to be able to express myself. But it was difficult to do so because I had made this agreement in the past to somebody else. The truth is, in order to really escape the worthiness trap, you need to come up with your own agreements, right? You need to come up with your own ways that you want to work, that you want to function. And so I was like, all right, well, let me just make a new agreement, right? Because it's that simple. You can make agreements left and right, right? How about I make an agreement that I can express myself really well, right? I read this every day, that I am a linguist, right? I'm a person who can use their words effectively to get their point across, right? I'm not annoying. I'm actually a linguist. That is what I am. That's my new agreement. This is who I am. This is what I do. And so this is an agreement that I made to myself. I've created it, and it's a positive agreement that fulfills my desires, right? Never make an agreement that deters you from whatever it is that you want to do. That is the number one key. Now, number two, never take anything personal. Like for real, never take anything personal, because people will always tell you the stuff. They were all just to tell you stuff, because look, man, this world is getting closer and closer to being founded on negativity when it comes to social interactions, right? Everybody like will just say something negative because now it's cool to be negative. It's funny to be negative, right?
You know how you always have some people, this is a great example, how you have people. Me and you can talk about a movie, right? We can talk about Titanic. Wow, man, Titanic, one of the biggest movies of all time. Fucking great movie. You'll go, yes, it was a great movie. And one guy, for no reason, go, I fucking hated it.
Somebody will just literally just boom, right? Right away turn negative, and it's very, very hard for you to fit into this environment when you're just constantly trying to be positive. But here's the truth. When you're surrounded by other people and everybody's just saying stuff and they're just going about their day, it's very easy to just take things personal, right? Somebody might insult you, but you don't understand that you don't need to take that personal. And so what you do is now you get defensive, right? Now you get super defensive. You say, what? What did you call me? Who am I? Huh? I'm what? You said, huh? Huh? Right? And so you get defensive, man. And so once you get defensive, boom, you took it personal and you slightly agreed to it, right? Because let's say somebody calls me ugly, right? Yo, Abdul, you ugly as hell. And what do I say? I say nothing. I don't care, right? I ignore it. But if I do respond and I say, huh? What'd you call me? That means I'm feeding that, right? I'm feeding this statement that this other person said and I'm taking it personal, which means that there's a part of me that actually agrees to it. Right? Because if I didn't agree to it and I didn't care and I didn't take it personal, it wouldn't bother me at all. I might even laugh at it, honestly. But the truth is, if you take what people say personal, you allow that energy to be fed, right? And when you feed this energy with your own words, you begin to slowly agree to it. So Never take anything personal. People will just tell you how they feel, and, or they might just be reactive. They'll just say stuff, right? They don't even know what they're saying half the time. So be very, very conscious to not take anything personal, because truly, at the end of the day, imagine how many things you say that you don't even mean, right? Always understand that people say things that they don't mean. It's just very unconscious, and it's just a part of the way that they are, and it's okay, right? If you can accept them for who they are, you will accept yourself for the way you are, and you won't take anything personal. Now, number three, people. You need clarity, right? If you don't know how it would feel to actually be worthy, you don't know what you're going towards, right? The goal is to know where you are, right? To know where you are, to know where you want to go, and to bridge this gap by using your emotion. You want to use your emotion, right? So when I say you need clarity, you need to focus on what you want, right? What does it feel like to actually be worthy? What would it look like? How would you act? How would you talk? How would you walk? How would you carry yourself? What is your demeanor? What is the aura, right? And you need to feel this now before anything happens. This is what's called the backwards law. You need to feel something. You need to be that before this thing actually happens. And what this does is it will bridge the gap from where you are to where you want to be by focusing consistently on what you want, man. This is the three easiest, most simplest, practical way to escape the worthiness trap, people. I try to make everything that I say very practical, very easy to understand, because I know that when I was trying to learn all of this, there's a lot of things, a lot of knowledge that I was just sucking up and absorbing and learning, but it wasn't easy to apply. And so, look, create new agreements, right? Very easy, very practical. You create it. Never take anything personal. This, of course, takes practice, but it's very practical as well, because if you understand that that person doesn't actually mean what they say, you won't take it personal, right? Because it's just another thing that they're just saying, right? So for example, imagine this. Your mom comes home after work. She had a rough day at work and she's feeling very irritated. And there you are, just chilling, not doing anything, minding your own business. And then she goes to the dishes, right? And she sees that the dishes are not done. She blows up. This has nothing to do with you. On a regular day, let's say she had a good day at work, she might go and do those dishes and not bother you at all. But because she's already emotionally irritated, she blows up on you. She says, man, you're just so lazy. You're this, you're that, you're that. And so you can understand that this person is just emotionally irritated, right? They don't have that much patience. And what they will do is they will begin to be very, very negative towards you. And if you were to take that personal, you would begin to agree to that, and your life would completely change, because now you would be expressing yourself less. You would actually feel awful about yourself, right? And you don't wanna be as happy. So never take anything personal. And clarity, make sure you know what you want. Feel it every day and work toward it by bridging the gap using your emotion, man. Use your emotion, feel what it would feel like. Walk the way that you would walk if you were worthy. Talk the way you would talk if you were accepting yourself and other people accepted you. Don't wait for people to accept you to feel accepted. Feel accepted, feel worthy, and then life will reflect that, because life is a reflection of who you are, not what you do. So at your identity, feel the acceptance, feel the worthy, and be completely you. I love you guys. I appreciate you. My name is Abdul, and I'm here to help people develop their lives, man. I hope this video helps you out. I hope your life begins to change once you apply this, but understand that it takes practice, so practice every day. Thank you for watching this video. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll respond to any comment, any question that you have. So thank you. I love you. I appreciate you. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day, man. Peace.